morning, everyone. We are from Georgia State University, and we are very happy to be here. It's been a great experience being able to partner with the university here in Oaxaca. It's a pleasure to be able to observe Mr. Juan's class. It's been very great to see you guys practicing English and learning. It's very encouraging to see you guys here. And so we're just so happy to be here. My name is Drew, and these are my colleagues. Introduce yourself.
I'm Katie.
And I'm Jack. We're very honored to be here. Excellent teacher, has allowed us to be here. So we hope to work with you.
Very happy to be here.
So we're going to have a presentation today on second conditionals. This was a request from your teacher, so this is not anything crazy. But we're going to have a 40-question test at the end. Okay? I'm just kidding. No test. So what we're going to do is we're going to review what second conditional is. We'll teach you the structure and the grammar of it. We'll do a couple activities, and then we have a fun game at the end for the structure. Okay?
So if you're texting, you want to say, just kidding, you just go to JK.
Okay, so this is the structure of the second conditional. So it's going to be an if statement. So here's an example. We're going to use the past simple. It's like the past tense of a verb. And then we're going to be using the verb would. You see it in these examples here. So Q is for question, A is for answer. So here's an example. If you made, so that's the past tense of make. If you made one change in the world, what would you do? So would the modal here. So you can see the structure. You have the if, you have the past simple verb, and then you have the modal would. And of course you have your subjects here.
Let's ask them to say that first sentence.
Yeah, so can you guys read this first sentence for me?
If you made one change in the world, what would you do?
Perfect. And the answer to this question, if I made one change in the world, I would end poverty. So can you read that one for me?
If I made one change in the world, I would end poverty.
Perfect. So we're going to focus on that structure. We have if, past simple, and would. Those are the three main parts of this structure, our if statements. So if you guys can write that down, we'll give you a second if you want to jot it down for your notes. And then we're going to do some activities.
And the would has, strange English spelling. It sounds just like the, like something made of wood, W-O-O-D. It sounds the same. So everybody say wood.
Wood.
Same pronunciation. Everybody need to write it down? Move on?
No.
No? Okay. And for our next activity, we're going to ask you to separate into groups of four. So once you finish writing it down, you can get into groups of four. Do some practice with this. So I'll go over the instructions first. So in your group, these are some practice questions using the second conditional. So I want you to take turns in your group answering these questions together. So for example, me and Jamie will show you how to practice. So Jamie, if you went back in time, what year would you go to?
I went back in time. I would go back to 2009 because I graduated.
So she used the structure. If I could go back in time, I would go to 2009 because that's when I graduated. We'll do another example with Jeff. Jeff, if you had special power, what would you be able to do?
If I had a special power, I would want to be able to speak Spanish.
Perfect. So, do you understand how the activity works?
Yeah.
Okay, so practice with your group. You can ask each other these questions. And one important thing, I want you to choose your favorite answer and you'll present. Have one presenter. So whoever,
you write it down.
Yeah, you can write down your favorite answer and then you'll present it to the class at the end, okay? Alright?
Yeah.
In if you have any questions about any vocabulary, the structure, just ask Jack, Jamie, or me. We can help you.
We'll be on your end to help you.
Hey, guys.
Hey guys, you can have your attention please for your presentations. Don't be nervous, you guys are all doing great. Your questions are very good. We're nervous too, so it's okay. So, from the first group, should I start? Okay, let's start here. So, we got everybody's attention, they're going to present their question and their answer using the second condition.
And we have a different answer.
But you so you ask the question and you answer.
Read minds, good. So read minds.
Yeah.
Know what you're thinking. That's a good special power. Thank you. That's very good.
We're going to read the question that we do.
Okay. So they made their own question. They're very ambitious students.
If you travel, where will you go?
If I travel, I will to go to Spain.
Good. Thank you. Very good question. Here. Yes.
If you want back in the time, what do you go to?
If you had a special power, what would you be able to do?
If I had a special power, I would be able to speak Dutch.
Speak Dutch. So Dutch is the language they speak in the Netherlands.
Oh.
Yes.
And because I want to live in Amsterdam.
Yes. Speak Dutch then. Yes. Beautiful place.
Amsterdam is a wonderful city. Yes.
Thank you guys.
I want to go to 80s for dancing disco until the sunset.
Oh, nice. Disco until the sunset. Okay, now final group here.
Oh, yeah. If you had a special power, what would you be able to do?
If I had a special power, I would have the power to stay.
Alright, we'll have four more practice questions, and so whoever did not speak has to speak next time, okay? So in the next round, if you did not speak this time, you have to speak next time. And no silence, please. We'll do a couple practice ones. You can listen to Jack and Jamie.
So Jack, if you had a new life, what would you be?
And if you spoke three other languages, what would they be?
If you won billions of dollars, what would you do with it?
If you dated any celebrity, who would it be? Donald Duck or Mickey Mouse?
Anybody understand the question?
Yeah.
Practice again. And then we'll have two different presenters for next time, okay? Okay, guys, we're going to present. Thank you. We're going to start over here. We're going to finish. So you guys can listen up. We're going to do our first group. Our next group right here. So this group here.
If I spoke three other languages, I would to speak French, Italian, Chinese.
French, Italian, and Chinese. Wow,
that's good. That's
very interesting. This group over here. Who? Oh, okay. Get you a celebrity. That's good. This group back here.
If you spoke three other languages, what would they be?
If I spoke three other languages, they would be French, English, and Sabotin.
You speak English. That's good though. Thank you, thank you. That's great. Alright guys, for our last thing we're going to do a game. So I need you to push the chairs to the side. Push the chairs to the side and stand up. Stand in the middle. Options. For example, would you rather be famous or would you rather have all the money in the world? You choose one. And so I'll say the first one, like, would you rather be famous? And if you want to be famous, go to that side of the room. If you'd rather have all the money in the world, you go to that side of the room.
He's asking, what do you prefer?
Yeah, what would you rather is what do you prefer? Yes, we're practicing using that would. Yes, and so what's going to happen is when you separate, I'll ask one of you on each side, like, would you rather be famous or have all the money in the world? And I'll point to you, and you would say, I would rather be famous. Come over here. Would you rather be famous or have all the money in the world? I'll point to you, and you say, I would rather have all the money in the world.
And explain why.
Alright, would you rather be a master of every musical instrument, so play every instrument, or would you rather be fluent in every language? Languages? Instruments. So you can play guitar, piano, every language, every musical instrument.
Okay, 1, 2, 3,
guys, I? Okay, so I'm going to ask you a question. Would you rather be a master of every musical instrument or be fluent in every language?
I would rather be a master of every musical instrument.
Perfect. And would you, sir, rather be a master of every musical instrument or fluent in every language?
I would rather be fluent in every language.
Perfect. Great. That was great, guys. All right.
Okay, I think that was our last one. All right, thank you, guys. Thank you.